To increase your wealth, increase your service. All you have to do is apply this simple law to your business or profession. Let me illustrate how with an example from the everyday competitive world in which we live. Let us consider an intersection, one of those busy ones where two main streets cross, and imagine that there are four filling stations, one in each corner. Would you say there is a competition at that intersection? I certainly would not. There is no such thing as competition, except for those people who choose to place themselves in competition. If you see the situation as competitive, then you will indeed be in competition with the other filling stations. You are setting yourself up to lose. Competition is a win-lose situation. Either I win and the rest of you lose, or I lose and one of you wins. It happens every day. Filling station number one lowers its price to try to get ahead of the competition. Stations two and four follow suit, while station three goes even a cent lower. Stations two and four are now hurting, so the next day they lower their price 2 cents, and so it goes. To maintain themselves, the stations must cut service and cut wages. It's a rat race, everybody worrying, everybody having ulcers, everybody having problems making ends meet. When you drive your car in, typically you have to wait. The owner feels pressured, placing himself and his feelings first. He does not check the oil, the battery, water, or tires, nor wash the windshield. By trying to be competitive, these stations would price themselves right out of business. Not even the customer would win, because if they all fail, then he has to find somewhere else to get gas. Or if only one gas station remains, then he might have to pay an exorbitant price. There are not very many winners in a competitive situation. Now let's suppose that station number two gets tired of that rat race. He decides to come to a Psi class and finds out there is another way. I win, you win. He no longer is interested in being in competition with the others. He sets a fair price on his gas. Quite often, it will be 2 or 3 cents per gallon higher than the surrounding places. It is a fair price because he gives you the very best service in town, and he pays the highest wages to his attendants. When you drive into his service station, you most certainly will not have to wait. He doesn't have one attendant, but he has 2 or 3. You get immediate service. While one attendant is filling the tank, the other is up front cleaning your windows and checking under the hood, the battery, fan belt, air filter, as well as the oil. They even look at the tires. All this without being asked. Why does the station do all this? To sell you a new fan belt or air filter? No, their object is to provide you with the best service possible, to make sure you get where you're going without problems, to catch any problems before they become big. This station sincerely gives you the best service available. Now, when you do have a problem, where do you think you will go? When the tires need rotating, or when the carburetor needs tuning up, or the battery needs replacing, which station will get your business? I know which one will get mine.